is Radio 2
on BBC Sounds.
And on your smart speaker.
Play BBC Radio 2.
BBC News at midday. This is Catherine Cracknell. Passengers arriving at some of Britain's busiest airports are facing severe disruption at the start of the bank holiday weekend and half term. A Border Force IT issue has meant e-gates aren't working properly and long queues have been reported at passport control areas. Simon Jones reports.
The e-gate system, which allows air passengers to scan their own passports when they arrive in the UK, went down last night. All airports across the country are affected, meaning people flying in are having to queue to get their passports checked manually. One passenger at Gatwick described the situation as an utter joke. Another at Heathrow spoke of the mother of all queues. The Home Office said it was working to resolve the problem as quickly as possible. There have also been IT issues at the Port of Dover, this time for people trying to leave the country.
The Post Office has apologised after documents were uncovered showing racist language was used to categorise workers being investigated as part of the Horizon computer scandal. Hundreds of sub-postmasters were wrongly prosecuted for theft and false accounting because of problems with the IT system. ITV said it feels badly let down by Philip Schofield and is no longer working with the former This Morning presenter. Mr. Schofield's revealed he lied to conceal an affair with a younger male colleague. A senior Ukrainian official has told the BBC his country is ready to launch a long-awaited counter-offensive against Russian forces. The BBC's diplomatic correspondent James Landale says Kiev will not begin the attack until it's absolutely ready to go.
There is a fear amongst some here within Kiev that it might not deliver results quick enough for some of the Western allies out there, and there is a fear that perhaps support in the West might wobble a bit if there is not enough quick victories, enough progress when this offensive comes. And that's one of the reasons why Ukraine is making it very, very sure that they choose the moment when they think it's right to go.
Japan's government says it wants to halve the levels of pollen over the next 30 years to tackle the soaring number of cases of hay fever. The plan includes reducing the size of Japanese cedar forests, which are among the biggest pollen emitters. Home builders will be encouraged to use cedar wood, while low pollen alternatives will be planted in their place. The British cyclist Geraint Thomas will defend a 26-second lead over his nearest rival, Primoz Roglic, in today's crucial stage of the Giro d'Italia. Thomas, who's 37, is attempting to win the competition for the first time. BBC Sport's Tom Brown says today's time trial will decide the outcome of the entire three-week race.
Geraint Thomas, no one's favourite really to win here, but now suddenly has it all to lose as he sits there in pink. But of course, he's a great time trialist, a very experienced competitor now. I think around 5 o'clock UK time, put your tellies on, we're in for a dramatic finish.
And Henry Kissinger, who was one of the dominant figures in 20th century US diplomacy, is 100 years old today. He served as National Security Advisor and Secretary of State in the 1960s and 70s. That's the BBC News at 3 minutes past 12.
Thank you, Catherine.
Now, Radio 2. This is Claudia Winkleman. BBC.